BlogTalkRadio.
Praise the Lord, Toronto! Come on and give God some praise in this place. If you know He's an awesome God, clap your hands with us and help us sing tonight.
Good. That really blessed us. I think I have a caller, Cole. Let's see if somebody wants to make a comment. Good morning. Okay. Your area code 917. You want to make a comment? You're on Reaching Higher.
How you doing, Carlton?
Good.
My comment, going back to what you stated about media and the controversies in the church, and there's media, black gospel radio stations or religious media have a responsibility to report those controversies or those issues. And I clearly believe that they do, based upon the fact that the church should not be ignorant or left in the dark just because a situation happens or occurs in the church or among church people or with people who are supposed to be church people or sanctified or saved people. And they have a responsibility to report those things, otherwise people would not know what was going on. They would be kept in the dark, and it is news, so they have a responsibility to report the news, and people
okay.
have a right to be informed.
Okay, great. Do you feel like I should be riding in my car and somebody say go to this website and read about some accusations and a divorce of one of our great gospel singers? You think that's okay?
I do believe that's okay. I believe they should have gone a step further. They should have told you what the controversy was. And then you go if you wanted to. That's because they alluded to something. It lit a fire in you, and you decide you go and check it out. But I do think they have a responsibility to disclose whatever they're telling you to go seek out so that people will know, because there are a lot of people who based upon that, would not have gone to seek it out. And
okay.
It should be out there. It really should be out there. If you go to biblical scripture, you find out what people were things were said about certain people who were supposed to be of the cloth, who were supposed to be religious people in certain positions. When you go into the Gospels, you hear Peter talk about Balak. All right, with the lamb. You hear Peter talk about the lamb. You hear Paul make mention of some people who have turned away from the scriptures and began to preach their own thing. People
okay.
don't know this unless you disclose it. And so things need to be disclosed. Otherwise, people sit up under people not realizing that certain things are going on. And so the cloth, there's a saying in biblical scripture that says what's done in dark comes to light. Our light happens to be media that it comes to. And if it doesn't come to light, then people can't see it or hear about it. So then you're keeping them in the dark.
Wow.
But what purpose? What purpose does it serve? It serves none. But you get in the information and you go and telling sister so and so, and you go and
that's,
she telling sister so and so.
That's
gossip.
That's gossip.
Yes. And
I agree with both of you to a degree, because I believe that it's information, it's news, and it has to be shared. But what I'm afraid of is, how do we share the information? Do we share the information in the light of we need to pray and we need to be aware that there's an issue going on and we need to lift these people up? Or, like a lot of church folk I know, will spread the gossip?
Well,
anybody?
Let me just say this.
Okay.
Gossip and informing the public is two different things, but it could be seen as being one and the same, because it's how you perceive it, how you receive that. And by the way, this is Bernadine. How you doing, Carlton? talking.
Good. Thank you for calling.
I'm from media, so, you know, I've been in media for over 40 years. And basically this is what I do. And so, you know, and I have my own blog, and basically I talk about these things as they come up. And a lot of times when I'm doing it, I focus basically upon what my when I'm writing on my blog, which is bsmith101.wordpress.com. When I'm writing on my blog about stuff that's happening in the church that somebody has done or said, take for instance, as you said, Deidre Catton. Well, he released that on Facebook that his wife was in adultery with this person. It was not. I saw the radio station printed it, and I read the title of it. I did not read the article. And later on that evening, I read the article. And I was really surprised because in that article, I read that Deidre Catton had a child out of wedlock and that he actually had been the adulterer. And here was the case of the adulterer calling his wife an adulterer and a friend. And I'm thinking, how weird is this? But you wouldn't know that if somebody hadn't published that. But also the other fact, because he would have read his take on it when he published that his wife is an adulterer, not realizing that a year ago, two years ago, she divorced him. Evidently, he had been fooling around, and then he had this child. I didn't even know they were divorced because to me, they were like the ultimate couple. I didn't know that they were even having any problems. I didn't even know that he was no longer the head pastor of his father's church, but I read it in the article. And this is what I'm talking about. You need to be informed because we walk around and we look at these people, we hear these people, we find their music. And a lot of times, you know, because you're in the media and I'm in media and you know some artists and you hear what they have to say about people behind the scenes. And you hear a lot of times that a lot of these people are not who we perceive them to be as being, you know, saved and sanctified and living a life of someone who's saved and sanctified.
Right.
And they don't necessarily call names. But we look at these people and believing they're all living the life of being saved and sanctified until something comes up in media. And then
You wanted to make a comment, then I'll make a comment.
But at the end of the day, who cares? I don't care. I don't care about who he slept with. That's none of my business at the end of the day. And his ministry has nothing to do with what he does behind closed doors. God can use a bum. I mean, everybody, when you close your doors, I'm sure you do some stuff that's, you know, not in line with. You do some stuff that's not in line with the word of God yourself, you know, and I'm pretty sure you don't want that out there. Should we put your information? Should people be informed about what you doing behind closed doors too? I mean, you saying you in media as well. Should people be informed about that in your church? And then, you know, that just kind of takes away from your ministry.
We're not disputing his gifts. In fact, it was not anybody outside of his immediate space but him who disclosed that information about his wife and Isaac Kareem being adulterous. Based upon him doing that is how most people found out that, like me, that he had a child out of wedlock because he did that.
But couldn't it have stopped there when he put the information out? Why did we have to hear about it on this radio station, social media site? It became entertainment at that point. And that's not my business.
I'm not really
connected to this guy. I don't even know who this guy is. You know what I'm saying?
That y'all guys don't agree. And I think that both of you have great points and great information to share. My question this morning was, how should the Christian media handle the scandals? Let me ask both of you. I posted a picture last week of Bishop Larry Trotter in the bathtub with his granddaughter.
I did the same.
And
Cole, I put it on my blog.
I had a pastor immediately jump me for that.
I had somebody who evidently was from his church made a comment to me. But I have to say this, that when this, first of all, like Deidre Caddy, it was Bishop Trotter who released the picture. The picture was released from somebody in his immediate space. And that's how we got the information. And
right.
Well, if it's put out there, does media
have a responsibility to discuss?
No. Here's where we go to what is done in dark comes to light.
Wow.
And a lot of times it comes to light by error, but it comes to light.
Okay,
well,
I believe that the healthy discussion...
Let me say this, Cole, and I'm going to give you time. The healthy discussion of these incidents may absolutely edify somebody who is a little bit confused of why a bishop should be in there. A healthy discussion, you know, without defaming anybody or gossiping, but a healthy discussion about it, people can be edified or benefited at the end of the day. Do you think so, Cole?
I still see no purpose. It's not my business. I mean, we all know what adultery is. We all know what these issues is. Now, I did bring up another point when we were talking too. There was another artist, gospel artist, who got arrested for pled guilty for burning his child and scalding hot water. It was actually his stepchild. And so in that case right there, that was regular news. You know, I mean, that came on the regular news. That's a court thing. But again, for us to go back and discuss it, you know, it's pointless to me. It's pointless to me because, again, everybody is nobody without sin, and you have to think about yourself. I had personal opinions that I actually shared with that particular artist on Twitter, but like to put it up on a social media site as entertainment, it's not entertainment. It's not entertainment. For me.
Okay. I'm gonna give my sister a chance to respond. Then I'll kind of wrap up with some scripture about how I feel has to do with this. Go ahead, my sister. You want to say something in response?
I believe that your pastor, the bishop or whoever came to you, really should not have done that because biblical scripture says that a bishop has to be faultless. It also says to us that we have to even avoid the illusion that something is going wrong or that we're doing something wrong because we cannot fall into these kinds of situations. We cannot be held up where people look at us with curious eyes. We must be clean. We must be holy. We must be upright, and we have to be faultless. And so biblical scripture tells us that it is in scripture. It is in scripture where it says that only what you do for God will last. It's there. All right. This is scripture. And when people fall out of line with scripture and they do things that come to the attention or should be brought to the attention of people at large, then it is the responsibility of those who have access to get it there to do so. Because if you hold it, you're like the watchman. And our job as the watchman is to blow the horn. And if we fail to blow the horn, then we are held accountable for what we did not do and for those who fell prey to those people or whatever circumstances that we did not warn them of. You know what I'm saying?
Amen. I thank you for those points, my brother and sister. I just believe this echoes what Cole is saying in Matthew 18 and 15. It says in the New International Version, if your brother sins against you, go and show him his fault just between the two of you. If he listens to you, you have won your brother over. And I want to also say that the Bible reported Moses as a liar. The Bible reported David as an adulterer.
Mm-hmm.
The Bible reported Paul as a prosecutor, mm-hmm. and a person who had a thorn in the flesh. So the Bible is the biggest media example of reporting sin, not for it to be a detriment to anybody, but it reported to let you know that God can use anybody and that gifts are given without repentance. But the story should not end there.
We see your glory, Lord. You're high and you're lifted up, and your train fills the timber. We worship you, we worship you, we worship you, we worship you. Oh, we worship you. Oh, we bow down in your presence as the angels do, and we cry, holy, 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 holy.
I have a caller, Erica 111. You're on the air.
Hallelujah! This is Dennis C. Latham, man. What's happening, Cole? And welcome, hello to the host.
Hallelujah!
Now, Cole, no, I'm about to drop it, but to Carlton Burgess, you have a very beautiful broadcast. I ain't going to call it a show. Now, I know
okay.
we as people are used to calling these things a show, but I'm not going to call this a show. I'm going to call this a broadcast because this is bringing some stuff here. Let me say this, and I posted this scripture, Proverbs 19 and 17. He that hath pity upon the poor lendeth unto the Lord, and that which he hath given will he pay him again. So this is what they need to be teaching up in these places, because if they spent their time doing this, teaching people to have pity on the poor, which is lending to the Lord and letting the Lord repay you back instead of waiting for those who are poor to pay you back, if they spent time on letting God provide instead of man provide, they wouldn't have time to be up in this mess. And two last quick things. Gossip is more of lies, slander, defamation of character, and speculation. But God is not against the truth. In Ezekiel 33:6 say, when you got these false prophets out here, you have to be careful. But Ezekiel 33:6 says, if the sword come and the watchman does not sound the trumpet,
that's right.
anyone who dies will die in their own iniquity.
That's right.
But their blood, God is going to hold on their hands. So if Cole, if you sitting up under a pastor who's a false prophet, and I don't tell you, God gonna hold that on my hands, okay?
That's
but see, because
right.
I love you, I'm gonna tell you, and I'm
cool.
done. Hallelujah!
praise God for the saints that call in. Did you want to say something?
Yes, first of all, to your friend, the Bible says, to forsake not the assembly of the righteous. And we can all go in church and find different things that we don't like or things that are going wrong. And the devil wants us to do that because he doesn't want anybody in church. And therefore, a lot of people have turned against the church. And there's no real church organization that's not organized. All church is organized. Somebody is at the top and somebody else is underneath them. So there is some level of organization, whether they say it or not. The only way you'll find something that's not organized is you're sitting all by yourself. But let me go back to media. Once media does have a responsibility to disclose news. Once the news is out there and the people run with it, then that's the people running with it. They become the gossipers. They become the people to pick up or take with it whatever they want to take out of whatever they heard. But the media's responsibility is to disclose information. And you cannot fault media, whether it be gospel media or NBC, ABC, CNN, or whatever, for disclosing news. And these things are news to the people who are within the church, whether we like it or not. I did, Carlton, like, he missed what you said about the Bible, in that the Bible discloses David as being an adulterer and those things. And it's true, if in biblical text, God does not keep these things secret. So therefore, why should we want to hold what you have classified as religious media hostage by saying you can't do it because this is, you know, these are church people and they're untouchable and you can't talk about them. And no matter what they do, you know, let's keep it hush up. That's not right. People won't know. And there's some people who are dangerous, and people need to know that they are dangerous. And some of these, and a lot of these issues have to be broke. Some people won't realize that they're doing something wrong. And a lot of times, scandal comes to bring you to your knees. So it will humble you. And a lot of times, you're facing situations because it came out and people found out that you do some introspection. Because some of us think we're so big and so untouchable and we're so holy and we're so godly that we can't do anything wrong. And then something flashes us in the face, and we're hit with a situation that goes around all the churches, and it makes us really look at what we're saying and what we're doing. So a lot of times when you look at this, and it is a matter of perspective, when you look at this and you say, wow, they shouldn't have said that, they shouldn't have printed that, they shouldn't have posted that, but sometimes it wasn't for the benefit of the people who are reading it, but it was for the benefit of those who did it.
Wow. Okay. Thank you so much, everybody that has called in and the statement, and my special guest, Cole, today. This has just been a great discussion, and I believe this has been more than this discussion. It's been ministry in the ears of our listeners, and if you miss this or you think somebody should hear it, it's available for playback 24/7 around 10:15. Share this with somebody. I'm not trying to pump my broadcast, but I believe it's information that could bless and edify somebody. I'm here every day, Monday through Friday, if this is your first time listening, 8 to 10, and we talk about issues like this one every day while playing great anointed gospel music from the pen of people like William Hubbard. I tell you, a person that I love, and I love your music, William. Thank you for talking today, William, my brother. And we're going to sing I Love You, Lord, today, this evening. Praise God. Love you guys. Join me tomorrow, same time, right here on Reaching Higher. And for all that has been said and done today, let the church say amen.
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 Nehemiah 8 and 6, and Ezra blessed the Lord, the great God, and all the people answered, amen, amen. Lifting up their hands, they bowed their heads and worshiped the Lord with their faces to the ground. When we receive a word from the Lord, our answer should be amen. Let the church say amen. Let the church say amen. Let the church say amen. God has spoken. So let the church say amen. Yeah. Let the church, let them say amen. If you believe the word, let the whole church say amen. God has spoken, so let the church say amen. Lift your hands, lift your hands. God has spoken, so let the church say amen. Oh, thank you, Lord. God has spoken, so let the church say
Bishop's Wife. You need to get your copy now.